and welcome to today's episode of Your Manchester. You all right, Mr. Adams?
I am. It's been a strange old day, Miss Scandal, hasn't it?
A very strange day, and we'll be touching on that a little bit later, won't we?
Yeah, reflecting, of course, on that sad news that Paul O'Grady has passed away. But we've got a jam-packed show.
We have
lots
indeed.
Of things coming up.
We have. We're going to be talking about The Bodyguard coming to us soon here in Manchester.
Very exciting. I love a bit of Whitney.
And also looking forward to Trafford Pride.
Yes, of course.
So exciting. We've got loads on the show. This is how your show's looking. But first, Paul O'Grady to me was the greatest of entertainers, and I'm not behind the door at saying this. I met him only twice, both times right here in Manchester, where he gave up his time to speak to me and inspire me about drag and choosing drag as my chosen career. He gave me time and words that still, to this day, keep my career going. A word used perhaps too often is icon, but to me, he really was the biggest icon of my chosen career. In the conversations that I had with him, he told me that drag was changing, that and the most important thing for longevity was to build a character and the performance will come easy. He told me to focus on a family member that would do the things that your drag character wouldn't. He told me about the strong women in his life, and so I focused hard on picking elements of my own family to use within my drag character. On the second time I met him, only a few years ago, I was bowled over to see that he had remembered me, and he asked after the name that I chose for drag. The very name Scandal is actually a dedication to his drag persona, of course, Lily Savage. He gave me his time and his experience, something that I found invaluable throughout the quarter of a century that I've been doing this job.
Fantastic, wasn't he? Of course, from the Northwest, born on Merseyside, in more recent years, better known as a TV presenter, he hosted a number of game shows, including Blankety Blank as Lily Savage in the late 90s. His career spanned more than 30 years, during of which, of course, he hosted the Paul O'Grady Show, Blind Date, and more recently, For the Love of Dogs at Battersea Cats and Dogs Home. And as well, he was also an actor, featured more recently on Doctor Who and Holby City. And as Belinda said, he began his career as Lily Savage in the 1970s, and the act later gained traction at the Royal Vauxhall Tavern Cabaret Club, where he was a prominent advocate of LGBT plus issues. Now, the Savage persona propelled him to TV and radio stardom, of course. He remained in character and took over from Paul Yates as the on-the-bed presenter on The Big Breakfast in 1995. And then, of course, Blankety Blank, which ran until 2002, would showcase his dry humour. Then, during my own youth, of course, it was all of those comedy chat shows, which would be on ITV and Channel 4, such as The Paul O'Grady Show and Paul O'Grady Live in 2010, which featured guests like Kylie Minogue, Tom Jones and Michael McIntyre.
Wow.
Now, speaking to their human rights campaigner, Peter Tatchell said, Paul wasn't just a brilliant comedian and broadcast personality, but a much admired campaigner for LGBT plus equality and animal rights. And speaking on her programme this morning, Lorraine Kelly described him as a really special man and funny, fearless, brave, kind and wise.
In his statement, his husband announced the star, known for his drag queen persona, Lily Savage, died unexpectedly but peacefully on Tuesday evening. Andre, his husband, asked, at this difficult time, whilst we encourage you to celebrate his life, we also ask that you respect our privacy as we come to terms with this loss. He will be greatly missed by his loved ones, friends, family and animals, and all those that enjoyed his humour, wit and compassion. I mean,
it's sad, isn't it?
It's very, very, very sad, because he was a total legend. Mm. And so many people loved him.
They did, yeah, universally. I mean, a lot of people my age probably know him better as Paul O'Grady, compared to Lily Savage.
Yeah.
So I think perhaps a lot of people now, and we were saying this before we came on, it's very sad when you have to celebrate somebody's life when they're no longer with us.
Drag queen legend today, the quote that summed it all up for me was, a lot of us wouldn't be doing drag if it weren't for Paul O'Grady, because a lot of us have stole elements from what he did, the sharp wit, the sharp tongue, all that was kind of stolen and given almost permission to use after watching him and be so brilliant with Lily.
Yeah.
And joining us now is one of Paul O'Grady's closest friends, Mr. David Dale. Welcome to the show, David. How are you feeling today?
A bit numb, to be honest, and a bit devastated. So.
And you worked with Paul really closely for many years. Tell us about how you first met.
I first met Paul when I was judging him in a talent competition at the Black Cat in Camden Town. He was called Gene Savage. And he come on stage in a pair of brown leather shorts and a white T-shirt and a little blonde wig and some thigh-length boots and a whip. and did a number called Lesbian Butch Dyke, and he was absolutely terrible, and he didn't win the competition. But he was funny. He just made me laugh. He was comical. And some years after that, I had an idea for a trio act that I wanted to do. And he was working in an act called The Playgirls with a queen called Sandra Hush. And I asked them if they would like to join my act, and we started working together, and that was about 1983. And we've been friends ever since, really.
Now, a lot of people are talking about Paul O'Grady because of his wonderful Lily Savage, but I mean, you were close to him. I mean, what type of person was he?
I always felt the real Paul O'Grady was the person I knew, which was Lily Savage.
The most significant memory that you have of Paul is what?
Just his closeness, just his friendship, and just being there for me when I had anxiety and panic attacks. And I could guarantee that I would just have to call him and he would be there and would literally cry. He was just so supportive and always there for me when I was at my worst. So I would say those are my significant memories. Really, more than anything, it's friendship as opposed to as a performer. You know, as a performer, I knew him very well, but as a friend, I knew him better. He was more of a friend to me than anything else, yeah.
And how do you hope that people will remember Mr. O'Grady?
I don't think he'll ever be forgotten, to be honest. I think he'll go down in the annals of television history as a legend along the lines of people like Frankie Howard and Danny LaRue. And I think he'll always be one of those greats. And also the work he did with animals. I mean, he was very genuine about his animals and the way he felt about them. He was just a good egg.
Yeah. I think that really allowed us to see sort of the real Paul O'Grady, aside from Lily Savage and, of course, this sort of outrageous persona that he let sort of spill out across all of the different shows he did. We saw him on a more personal level there, didn't we?
Yeah, I think the thing is with him is he had his fingers in so many pies and he had so many interests and loves, performing and the dogs and the animals, and it was just another side to him. It was just lovely to see. It was a bit like Dr. Dolittle, I think, with a little bit of Snow White thrown in. You can imagine bluebirds landing on his finger as he's singing away to them, but flatly, I might add. But because he couldn't sing for toffee. But yeah, all those things about him will always be treasured, I think, as a television icon.
We were reading today a bit of a legend about Paul O'Grady. Do you want to explain what that story was?
Yeah, so it was the story about the time, I think it was 1987, Royal Vauxhall Tavern. Lily Savage is up on stage and there was a police raid, of course, in the midst
there.
Of the AIDS crisis.
Was there.
You were there.
I was
so
there.
Can you answer
we
this?
We were working together in our trio. There was three of us on stage. Yeah, the police did come in. They had rubber gloves on and everything. That's all true, yeah.
Is it true that Lily turned around and said that they were there to
help with the washing up?
Yeah, something like that. There was some sarcastic remark, but all the time the police were in, you see, it was coincidental because our act was a mime act, and there was three of us, but so we could do our changes. The other guy in the show and myself would go off and change, and Savage would stay on stage with the microphone and do a bit of patter. And it was at that precise moment that the police came in. So there was all kinds of things that came out of Savage's mouth.
Just before we let you go, David, what will you miss most about him?
Oh, my God. What won't I miss? I'm going to miss out endless telephone conversations that used to go on for literally hours. I can't remember the last time I saw Paul, but I remember the last time I spoke to him, and it was about 2 weeks ago. And he was talking about how exhausted he was doing Annie. But, yeah, I think it's going to be our long telephone conversations I'm going to miss. Who am I going to call now when I'm miserable? I don't know.
I'm right at the other end of the line for you, David, whenever you need to have a little chat.
Cheers, thank you.
But well, for now, though, unfortunately, on this program, we are out of time with this interview. But thank you so much for doing this.
Thanks, David.
I reached out to you today because I knew that today would be so difficult for you. But I only knew Lily Savage. I didn't know Paul O'Grady, and that's why it was important to get some perspective on this from somebody that actually knew the man behind the character. So thank you so much for your time today.
Our thoughts are with you, and of course,
you're welcome. Thanks for asking me.
Just like to thank you for all your emails and your cards. But whatever you are, boss, you're gone but not forgotten, kid. Give him a big cheer. Come on. Oh, God.
Remembering the life of Paul O'Grady, who passed away yesterday. Now,
we're going on a walk.
We are. Paul's been out and about, as ever. Where is he today?
Now, I've been working lots recently, but you know what? I've always got time for a bit of a ramble. And this week, I've come to Jubilee Colliery Nature Reserve. And it used to be a coal mine, so there's lots to see and to do. Jubilee Colliery is a nature reserve site which has been established on and around the site of a coal mine. I think this must have been one of the tunnels where the men would go underneath to go down the mine. Originally owned by the Edge Lane and Dry Cloth Colliery Company, it was bought in 1883 by the Platt Brothers and Company Limited. We love a bit of sunshine. I've been quite lucky with me rambles recently, haven't I? And I think I'm coming up to the mill right now, and I'm going to flip you round to show you what I can see. Lots and lots of history. Hope you've enjoyed it. And now, where will I be next week? Who knows? Find out only on Your Manchester. And it's back to the studio.
Well, we're very excited now as we are bringing in the stuff that I need. You got the stuff that I want. I will always love you because
like Whitney's
I'm
in the room.
Everyone that it's all in me. How many more can I do? I can't do any more. Do you know why? I have nothing.
Oh,
okay. Now then, let's bring our fabulous guest in. Emily May Walker joins us now from the Bodyguard. Welcome. How are you?
Hello, everybody.
Hello, I'm good. How are you guys? That was amazing singing.
Did you like that? Hey, yeah, train diet.
Can we get our Belinda apart in the Bodyguard?
Yes. I could make a bodyguard.
You could.
Yeah. We're not so much a bodyguard. I'd make a good doorstop. Why should people come and watch this version of The Bodyguard?
They should come watch this one because I'm in it, biased. But it's got all the classic Whitney songs that you perfectly sung just there.
Thank you.
It's a timeless love story. It's got cracking dancing with phenomenal dancers. Full pyrotechnics show. It's everything you want. It's full showbiz. You can't walk away unsatisfied.
And are you a Whitney fan yourself, Emily?
I am, and we've been going for about 3 months now, and I'm still a Whitney fan. So I think that shows that it's quite good because I listen to it every day.
it's yes, not Houston Overload, then.
No, do you know what? I'm still not bored of it. If it comes on the radio, I'm not mad about it. They're all bangers. You know, you can't go wrong. And there's such a broad range of songs. You go from like your slow ballads to your full pop, absolute iconic bangers. So you can't get bored of it because it's such different styles.
So of course, people know the 1991 film. Was it 1991? I think it was. How has it been adapted to make it such a powerful musical then?
Yeah, well, they've kept the main storyline. They've changed a few little bits and tweaked some things just to give you a bit of a shock and a jump. But the main arc is there, the love story, the angst, the jealousy is all still included. But it's just packed with as many Whitney songs as you can imagine.
Tell us about your character then.
So I play Nicky Marin. I am Rachel Marin's sister, and Rachel Marin is this big mega star. She is humongous. I'm her sister, and I am living in her shadow. I'm also a performer, but I'm not quite as good as Rachel Marin. And I'm a bit of a, I've become sort of her PA, and I'm always around, and I end up in a bit of a love triangle with her and the bodyguard. Well, I say a love triangle, it's very one-sided from me. And I end up getting in a bit of bother there. And without giving anything away, it gets a bit complicated.
Now, of course, your character didn't get a song in the film. Have you got songs in this, I'm guessing?
I do. I've got a little solo and then I do a little duet with Melody. So I get my little chance to shine. I've got a bit more, I'm a bit more packed out than the film. And I'm not as mean because I read the script for this before I watched the film and I was like, raw, she's nasty. And I'm not that bad. I'm not as bad as the film.
Well, of course, it all kicks off this Monday at the Palace Theatre and you're playing right up until the 15th of April. We cannot wait to see it.
We're there for it.
We're there for it.
I'm very excited. I know very little about this as a musical, but I'm very excited.
It is brilliant. Mm. I saw it a few years ago. And good. It's top notch.
I'm excited. Good. I'm glad you enjoy it.
No problem. Well, for now then, thank you so much for your time. Thank you, Andy. We'll catch you very, very soon. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, there you go.
It's been a busy month, hasn't it?
It's been a have you enjoyed yourself?
I have. We've been non-stop. I mean, you might have seen, we've launched our brand new TikTok series, all to do with Coronation Street.
We have. We managed to prank you as well, which was probably one of my highlights. And if that wasn't my highlight, I have to say my other highlight would be the pie maker.
Oh, yes. We loved that, didn't we?
There's so much to look upon. Let's have a look at this. Well, a very good evening to each everyone of you joining myself and Michael. How are you?
I'm very good. How are you?
I'm all right. Have you had a good week?
I have indeed. I was at Comic Relief last week.
You were?
I was indeed, yeah. Big red nose on my face, yeah.
It was good, wasn't it?
It was.
Traitors.
All over that.
Jujubee, hello. How are you?
So good. How are you? Thank you so much for having me.
Brian and Nick, all the way from Britain. Nick, how are you doing? You okay? Skateboarders labelled... and virgins in horrible video get amazing surprise amid bullying backlash.
This is a series where I show you two places around our beautiful city that you might not have even heard of, or that you might not know too much about.
These guys were surprisingly born here. We weren't expecting them. it just happened.
Hello, Matthew. How are you?
I'm all right. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Well, I don't know whether you knew this, actually. I am Bake Off champion. You're Manchester Bake Off champion. My brownies are to die for.
La, 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 la.
Tear, that was like ASMR.
I don't drink the whole fucking thing.
So when I'm not on the Your Manchester sofa, I'm often to be found at fundraising events. I base my act really on Tess Daly.
Okay.
Or does she copy me? I don't know.
Well, you see, I like to call myself the Gordon Ramsay of floristry, and I'm here to judge some flowers.
It's not as easy as what it looks.
No, it's not, is it? He made it look a bit
too easy.
Easier, didn't he?
Did either of you listen to anything that I taught you in that demonstration?
The teachers have been striking all throughout February and March, and I'm here to talk to some of the students on their opinions. Let's go find out. Yeah.
It's good to do a drama course from the comfort of your own bedroom.
Yeah.
Which is recyclable human beings.
And what do you mean by that? That's an interesting concept. How do you make a recyclable human being?
Well, so when they die and they're put in the ground.
You are a bunch of bastards!
Yeah. Oh dear, it's been eventful, hasn't it?
It's been eventful, and we've got a lot more to look forward to as well.
We have indeed, and so is one of our friends of the show as well. Without her, we wouldn't have had that lovely piece about the pie, would we?
The pie. And now, as I open any pie, all I'm going to hear in my ears is do 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 do. Honestly,
the darling Harriet Thorpe.
She's fully made it.
She has. She has been cast as Elaine Peacock in EastEnders. She's joining the square as the new landlady of the Queen Vic later in the year. Good on her, right?
Which is very, very, very.
From your Manchester to EastEnders, she's done well for herself.
Well, I mean, she was doing a little bit before she actually bumped into me. You know, she's done a fair bit. She's not had a bad career, let's put it that way. Touch wood for her. But yeah, she's going to be in there, Elaine Peacock, replacing Maria Friedman.
Yeah.
And as Linda Carter's
mum.
Linda Carter's mum. So much to look forward to.
Know, there is indeed. Including?
Including?
Trafford Pride.
Yay!
And well, to speak to us all about Trafford Pride now, which is upcoming in May, is Darren Adams. Hello to you, Darren.
Hello, how are you?
I'm very excited about this one. The smaller prize are becoming the more important prize. Why do you think that is?
I think people are kind of sticking
sort of hyper local. They're spending time in their local towns, but they're much more kind of community focused. There's kind of building a really nice reputation of kind of local people, delivered by and for local people.
And what have you guys got as part of your schedule at Pride in Trafford?
Brilliant. So we run for 4 days this year. So we open on the 17th through to the 20th of May. We've got loads of great stuff. Our festivals kind of focus more around arts based activity. So yeah, we sort of open with the annual progress flag. Progress flag raising event and launch the festival on the Wednesday. That ties in with International Day Against Homophobia, Transphobia and Biphobia. And then we run into lots of kind of great theatre performance and then closing towards the end on Saturday with a really nice family event, lots of outdoor performance, etc. And then Belinda Scandal is joining us in the evening as well.
And Darren, just tell me about, in terms of tickets and things, do you have to purchase a ticket? Is it a free event?
Some of our events, they're kind of standalone, so there are some ticket prices, but we do keep that really low cost. The kind of theatre and performance elements do require tickets, but over sort of almost 60% of the events are free to attend, so we encourage people to do that. But all of the information is, including tickets, are available from prideintrafford.org.
Would you agree that, let's ask you, what information would you give to people within our lovely regions, perhaps the surrounding regions, that wanted to set up their own Pride? What would you say the secret ingredients would be?
Long hours, probably plenty of commitment towards that. But I think just a strong idea. So you want to be, you know what you want to do, and use the community and listen to the community so that they're part of that. They shape those festivals. We've been really lucky that we've had so many people across Trafford that have inputted into our festival, kind of shaped how we do things, and I think that's made it much, much stronger.
Well, I'm excited, I'm giddy.
Oh yeah.
I'm giddy, can George. You tell I'm giddy?
Well, you haven't got long to wait. It's, of course, all kicking off in May. Thank you very much, Darren, for speaking to us today.
How fantastic.
I know. It looks very good, doesn't it?
It looks good.
Can you believe we are nearly at the end of the show? We have got something else to
do. Well, we're gonna finish with that, aren't we?
Yeah.
Because as much as we are a very, very live show, things don't always go according to plan. Mm. And obviously, a lot of our VTs that we create and curate, because I like that word at the moment, curate, ever since I've seen the Dead Egyptians, We fully have a lot of outtakes, and we're going to finish the show here, but we're going to let you lovely people out there make sure you subscribe, watch, tell all your friends about this lovely program.
Enjoy this.
Yeah. Only on
Your Manchester.
Oh, whoever just put that instructions book. Right. Are we ready? I feel like Fanny Craddock. My usual point on everything these days is that stress is caused by packaging. I don't know what I'm doing, I'll be honest with you, but we'll give it a whirl. I can't quite see how this works, but it goes. La 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 la. It's not going to be a very deep pie. We're going to add some chicken that's been pre-cooked. It's a great noise, actually. It's a great noise. Somebody's going to get food poisoning, it won't be me, so it's not a problem. Probably best to have a fire hydrant in place as well. I'm now closing my lid. Are you recording now?
I am.
It's beginning to smoke. It's got a full back page for notes. Everyone's singing that at the moment, you know. I love that song. I reckon I could do that myself, though.
You could?
I reckon I really could. But there definitely is a pie in there, and it looks like a pie. Ta-da! Right, well, you can all go now. We're going to tuck into about 50,000 pies. Back to us in the studio.
I don't drink the whole fucking thing.
10 out of 10.
That was really nice. You can tell it's been velvetized. I don't know what a velvetizer does, but it tastes like velvet.
It's frothy.
Is it worth £90?
£90?
Now listen, I don't even think they're that much anymore, you know. I'll have to check on that, but I think it's around about £90, yeah. But anyway, it was a gift.
I think I'll stick to going to other reputable coffee and hot beverage shops.
But then you've got to go to them, you can't make it at home, whereas we can make this at home.
That is a good point. And you think, the amount of times that we go to those shops...
They would send us one for free. Starbucks.
Costa Coffee.
Starbucks.
Or Costa Coffee.
Or Starbucks.
Or Cafe Nero.
Starbucks.
Pret a Manger.
Wimpy.
Wendy's.
Wendy's.
Taco Bell.
Coffee Foundation.
Dockyard Media City UK.
My front room.
My mother's front room.
Your mother's front room.
No, your mother's front room.
Your mother. Hey, your mother. Go on, do one.
Yes. Currently the interval. How has the show gone so far?
Well, it seems to be going very well. It's a very technical show. Lots of sound, lots of music. Have you got your microphone? No. Do you want to do it again?
Well, Mark, we'll catch you at the end of the show, but you've got to exit stage right.
Thank you very much indeed. Stage right is this way. I don't know why you pointed that way.
Thanks, Mark.
And there's a wall here, so...
I'll go stage left.
Thank you.
That's all right. I'm in the great British wilderness today. Yes, that's right, Mother's Day is happening this March, on March the 19th. But it's time to go and see some of the best... Right, let's redo that. Start again. Oh, you can hear me. I forgot you can hear me. Hiya, Frank. How's your day going? He's giving me a piece of my phone's out. I'm debating whether we should continue this. I don't know. What do you think? And I just go. Number one! I think you could go here for Mother's Day. This one does this and etc. British weather has other plans. Even need this video or just a game. It's like milking a cow. How does this thing even work? That's right. Shout out to my ex. I know you're out there, but you see? That's right. Shout out to my ex. I know you're out there. Let's do that again. That's right. Spinning Fields is home. Forgot what I was going to say. Wait. Let me check my... keep rolling. That is right. We are... He's wet.